Hello, and welcome to today's video where I'll be covering my webcomic process in Clip Studio Paint. In today's video, we'll be discussing more about Clip Studio Paint's speech bubble tools and how you can use them for your webcomic. Links to related tutorials will be down in the description box below. In the last video, we learned how to create speech bubbles using Clip Studio Paint's balloon and tail tools. To continue where we left off, we'll draw out some more speech bubbles. After you've drawn out your speech bubbles, you can enter text by going to the Text subtool. By clicking on your bubble, the text will automatically align itself with the center of the bubble, so you won't need to adjust it yourself. You can control the formatting and font of your text using the Customization options under the Tool Properties panel. Adjusting your bubble after text has been added will cause the text to move along with it, which makes editing it really simple and easy. Clip Studio Paint's Materials panel has some pre-made speech bubbles that you can drag and drop onto your canvas. These are found in the Balloon subfolder in the Manga Materials folder. There are speech and thought bubbles, narration bubbles, and some more dynamic bubbles for emotional lines like shouting and crying. I especially like using the shouting bubbles so I don't have to draw them out by hand every time. Once you've added a balloon material to your page, it can be completely customized and reshaped just like a normal balloon tool bubble. If you want to make your own reusable speech bubble materials, that can be done too. Make your speech bubble how you want it to look and add in some filler text. When your balloon is complete, go to Edit, Register Material, Image. For convenience, I recommend saving it to the Balloon folder along with all the other pre-made materials, but if you have a custom folder for your comic materials, you can save it there instead. Make sure you tag it appropriately, and then click OK. Now you can drag and drop this bubble onto your canvas, and it'll be fully customizable just like any other bubble. This is really useful for keeping your format consistent across pages. I personally like to use it for my chapter titles, so I can easily swap out the information without making any big changes to the format. Those are the basics for how to use Clip Studio Paint's balloon tools to add speech bubbles to your webcomic. Check the description below for my social media links and more tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.